I try very much all the time to help the young person to discover him or herself musically. But of course, as you may realize, this is a process which can only be done if one passes on to the student the idea that it's very necessary to have a craft, because a craft means that when you have your own ideas, you are able to evaluate them well. This is why I always encourage all the young people who work with me to write everything down that they think of whenever we start a project, to write down every theme that comes into their mind so that it can be explored. We explore them together. I help them to be able to evaluate their own music that they are writing.
She wanted us to become ourselves. One of the things she passed on to me as a teacher that I do is a simple thing, that she would never put a pencil mark on our music. She would never write on a student's works. And it was because she felt that if she marked the page, then the piece would become hers, and it would not be the student's. And it was really important to her that students develop their own voices. There was a concert at Banff where some music by Robert Rosen and Vivian Fung and a young student who was in his teens, and my music, and some of Violet's, kind of a tribute concert to her a few years before she died. And one of the things that was really quite remarkable was that there were five completely different composers on display there, a totally different way of thinking. And we pointed that out to her after the concert, and I think the biggest smile I'd ever seen on her face, it was as if we'd given her the most perfect tribute to her life's work, that she had made such a strong impression on five composers, and not one of them sounded like her. That was the best tribute anyone could give her.
She had a goal to make sure that listeners could understand the language of the 20th century. You know, it's pretty large goal, but I think that helped drive her.